Paris in the fall, the last months of the year and the end of the millennium. The city holds many memories for me, of cafes, of music, of love, and of death. As I picked myself up, all I could hear was the ceaseless drone of traffic. Life went on around me, but the explosion was to change my life forever.
Please, hold it right there.
Oh, don't shoot. I'm innocent. I'm an American.
Can't make up your mind, huh?
I demand to see the American consul.
Drop your weapons and get down on the ground.
Put that thing away, Sergeant Moon. I apologize, monsieur, but I cannot permit you to leave.
Am I under arrest?
Ah, no. I would simply like to ask you some questions. En avant, to the café, marche. What a mess. This bombing is an outrage, is it not?
Stop that, monsieur. Stop holding your breath at once.
Has it occurred to you that he may be dead, Mou?
Oui, monsieur. But I prefer to look on the bright side. Besides, I recall a case where the killer escaped by feigning death. However, in this case, the man is quite dead. Clearly, the killer knew of his presence and...
How many times have I warned you about premature extrapolation? All we know is that he is dead.
It seemed reasonable to assume...
A great detective assumes nothing. Take Maigret, for instance.
But he was a fictitious character, monsieur. Why, he was no more real than Poirot or Tintin.
That's different, Mou. They were comedy Belgians. Anyway, it is unlikely that even you will learn much from talking to the dead. Examine the girl and take her statement, if you can. Et maintenant, to business. Your name, please?
George Stobbart. I'm from California.
And what brings you to Paris, Monsieur Stobbart?
Travel. I'm touring Europe.
You chose well. The city is most beautiful at this time of year, no?
Yeah, I guess so, apart from the bomb blasts.
Were you in the vicinity of the café at the time of the explosion?
Yeah, I was sitting out on the sidewalk. I was lucky I wasn't killed. The inspector passed over my remark with no reaction.
Did you see the deceased enter the café?
Yes, I did.
Was he alone?
Yeah.
And did he say anything to you?
No. He was more interested in the waitress.
Did you see anyone else in the café?
Yeah, there was a guy dressed as a clown. He was carrying an accordion.
An accordion? Bon, the picture is forming in my mind, and it is not a pretty one. Is the girl all right, Mu?
She'll live. She confirms the American statement. A clown with an accordion, no doubt an elaborate and eccentric disguise.
Very well. Eh bien, I have heard enough.
What do you mean?
I am satisfied that you know nothing. You may leave. I hope this little incident does not spoil the rest of your vacation.
What about my personal safety? Can't you at least give me some advice?
What can I say? Stay alert and look out for suspicious characters.
And don't cross the road until the little man shows green.
Great advice.
I honestly believe you are in no danger, monsieur. Should you remember anything of importance, please contact me. My card.
Thanks.
That is all. You may go.
There's not much to go on, monsieur.
On the surface, no. But what lurks inside the subconscious? If the door can only be opened.
Are you serious, monsieur? I thought your interest in psychic detection was purely academic.
Academic? You are about to witness a scientific breakthrough.
The leading article referred to the visit of a Nobel Prize winner from some unpronounceable Eastern European state. That was the only news story. The rest was rumor, gossip, and sensationalism. Then I noticed the writing at the foot of the page. It read Salah ed-Din, 1345. Excuse me, mademoiselle? Hi, my name's George Stobbart.
Oh, an American by the sound of it.
Yeah, that's right. On holiday in Paris. Some holiday, huh?
You were here when the bomb went off?
Sure was. Sat right out front of the cafe.
Did you notice a middle-aged man, maybe 60, with an hat and overcoat?
I couldn't believe it. She hadn't even asked how I was feeling. Yeah, he went inside just before the bomb exploded. You weren't related to him, were you?
Oh no, nothing like that. I am Nicole Collard from La Liberté.
What's that, some kind of nightclub?
No, it is a newspaper.
You're a reporter?
I'm a freelance photojournalist.
Say, you could interview me about the bombing. You know, an eyewitness account. Minutes after the outrage that shook the whole of Paris. You know, real-life drama, human interest, that kind of stuff.
I'll just stick to the facts, thank you. Did you see who planted the bomb?
I know it sounds crazy, but he was dressed like a clown.
Oh, God. It's him again.
Do you know a police officer called Rosso?
Rosso? Our paths have a knack of crossing. If I didn't know better, I'd say it was deliberate. Have you seen Rosso? Is he here?
He's inside. attempting to question a witness with his psychic powers.
What? That guy is weird.
Yeah. Rosso didn't blink when I told him about the clown. It's as if he already knew.
That's typical of a cold fish like Rosso. I've seen cheeseburgers with more spunk.
You speak very good English for a French girl.
Thanks. You speak very good English for an American.
Have you met the clown before?
It's a long story.
I have plenty of time.
I don't.
Who's the guy you were supposed to meet?
His name was Planteur. I didn't know him, but he called me last night. He said he had a story which would interest me. He asked me to meet him at the café. I guess I'll never know what he wanted to tell me.
Not unless you have Rosso's gift for psychic interrogation. Why won't you tell me about this clown?
Why do you want to get involved?
Because he almost killed me. Isn't that reason enough?
I guess so. Listen, I'll give you my phone number. You help me with my story, and I'll let you in on what I know. And let's get one thing straight right now. This is strictly business.
Okay, it's a deal.
I have to go develop these pictures. A bientôt, monsieur.
Fine, I'll see you soon. Hi, can you spare a few minutes?
I thought you'd been arrested!
Nah, it was a misunderstanding.
When he pulled that gun, I thought that was it. Those automatics pack quite a punch, you know?
He made a mistake. He thought I was a terrorist.
You? A terrorist? Ha!
He was only doing his duty, I guess. Did you see a clown come by this way?
A clown? Like, in a circus?
Yeah, with makeup and a big red nose.
Huh! Those guys are funny, aren't they?
Not in my experience.
I love the circus, especially the horses.
You haven't answered my question. Have you seen a clown?
You think I've got time to watch everyone who passes by? Some of us have to work for a living.
Look, I know you're busy, but surely you'd have noticed a clown.
I told you already! I didn't see a thing!
He was wearing multicolored baggy trousers and makeup.
He'd be a poor sort of clown if he didn't.
Listen, I have to find that clown. He's a killer.
Say, who are you anyhow? A cop?
No, of course not. I mean, do I look like a cop?
I guess not. How do you know this guy's a killer? Did you see him in action?
Didn't you hear the explosion? The cafe was blown up.
I wondered what that bang was. Any bodies?
Yeah, an old man was killed.
Merd. I didn't think it was that serious. What about the waitress?
Oh, she's fine.
Thank the saints.
Did you see an old guy with a briefcase?
Wait, silly old coot. Do you know what he said to me? Work fascinates me, he says. I could watch it all day. Girl beat. I could have knocked his block off.
Did you recognize the old man?
No. Should I have done? Was he a celebrity?
No, but I guess he is now. His name was Plantard.
Was he the one who died in the cafe?
Yeah.
That's too bad. Now I wish I hadn't called him what I did. If only I could turn back the clock. If only I'd been more tolerant.
Regret and remorse are strange emotions. They really bring out the hammiest actors in people. Would you like to read my newspaper?
I haven't got time to read that. Can't you see I'm busy?
You could read it on your lunch break.
10 minutes is all I get. And if my boss had his way, I wouldn't get that. He'd have me on a drip, so I didn't have to stop to eat.
Oh, take the newspaper and quit complaining.
Bah! Look at this! Damn bleeding heart liberals! Tcha! Save the dolphins! Catch them and eat them, I say! All that fuss over a bunch of fish. Nah, that's more like it. Look at the size of those. Like champagne bottle corks, no? Ah, what's this? Saladin running in the Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe.
It's a racehorse?
A horse? A legend. Bucephalus reborn, mon ami. Like a streak of lightning she is. Do me a favor, won't you? Keep an eye on my hull. I'm off to put some money on that nag.
I found a T-shaped tool in the box. I didn't know what it was, but it looked useful. I lifted the cover to reveal what smelt like the entrance to a sewer. As I picked up the plastic ball, I realized it was intended to be worn. It was the clown's red nose. I scooped up the sodden tissue. It was cold and greasy, like breakfast leftovers. I took hold of the scrap of material and unsnagged it from the spike.
Hi there.
Hold it right there. You sewer rat. I knew you'd come back. And now I've got you.
What are you talking about?
You're trespassing. Come out of there, immediately.
That's what I'm trying to do. Give me your hand.
Ha! You won't catch me with tricks like that. Keep your distance, monsieur.
Okay.
Now, what were you looking for?
I was looking for a clown.
Huh, ridiculous. Do you really expect me to believe that?
He planted a bomb in the cafe and blew it up.
What? The cafe? Blown up? Mon Dieu, that is awful. And you say the person responsible was dressed as a clown?
That's right. He blew up the cafe, escaped into the sewer, changed his clothes, and came up here.
Ah, mon Dieu! Then, the man I chased, do you think that man and the clown are one and the same?
Well, yes, it had crossed my mind.
Ah, that still does not explain what you were doing down the sewer. For all I know, you are in league with him.
Oh no, I'm just a tourist.
Haha, most tourists are content with the Eiffel Tower, the Louvre, or the Pigalle. I didn't realize my waste pipes were such an attraction.
Was the guy you saw carrying a briefcase?
I didn't notice. Now are you going to leave, or do I have to call the police?
Perhaps you'd like to take a look at my card?
Mm-hmm. What is this? Inspector Augustin Rosso? What does that say? Hominoid Division?
A homicide. I think the ink's smudged.
Mm-hmm. Then you are not a tourist.
Okay, I'm not. I lied to you. And I'm sorry.
Don't apologize, monsieur. You know, I had a feeling there was something different about you. It is your posture, your poise. Oh, yes. There is no mistaking the bearing of a disciplined man. And I should know. I was in the army, you know. When I was your age, I was fighting for my life in the African desert. How can I help you, Inspector?
Let's start over from the beginning and tell it just like it was. Was the guy you saw carrying a briefcase?
Why, yes, he was. Clutched in his arms like a baby.
That belonged to his victim.
Oh, what do you think was in it? Drugs? Stolen jewels?
I don't know, but the killer thought it was worth a man's life.
Nothing is worth that, monsieur.
Do you know the waitress at the cafe?
You can't suspect her, surely.
Just answer the question, please.
Yes, I know her quite well, you could say. She came to work at the cafe 6, 7 months ago. I look forward all week to the relief she gives me when she visits.
Really? So you'd miss her if she wasn't there?
Oh, mais oui! Who else would I find to cut my toenails?
Tell me about the man you apprehended.
He was a mean one, monsieur. He grabbed me in an arm lock, his face suddenly next to mine. His grip was like iron, but he did not know what he was up against. Oh no, he made a big mistake when he took on one of the desert hyenas.
Yes, yes, I get the picture. Does the name Plantar mean anything to you?
No, it doesn't.
Does this piece of material mean anything to you?
That is the same cloth as the jacket I found. I'd recognize that pattern anywhere.
What does this tissue mean to you?
Nothing, monsieur. It's disgusting. What on earth possessed you to show it to me? Someone has emptied their nostrils into it.
Now, about the jacket you found. Do you have it here?
No, monsieur. One of the sleeves was badly torn, so I sent it for repair. A pity, because otherwise it was a fine piece of quality tailoring. It had the tailor's name inside on the label.
Where did you send the jacket?
I gave it to an itinerant Romani seamstress.
Just my luck. Was there anything in the jacket pockets?
Mm-hmm. Not a sou. You know what I think?
Do tell me.
Mm-hmm. He changed out of the clown suit and cunningly disguised himself as an ordinary person.
Looks like I'm up against a mastermind. What was the name on the label?
It was a foreign name. Tawdrick, I think.
Did you get the address?
There wasn't one, monsieur. Only a telephone number.
Well, I don't expect you to remember a phone number. You've only seen one.
74-98-08-59.
You're kidding. That's his phone number?
Yes, that is a little secret number that I learned in the desert. I was taught the technique by a Tuareg shaman.
That's incredible.
It comes in handy at the supermarket checkout. Do I get a reward?
Honesty, monsieur, is its own reward.
Then I'm glad I do not rely on honesty to pay the bills.
I have to be going. Thanks to your help, The citizens of Paris can sleep a little easier tonight.
Vraiment? I was only doing my duty, monsieur. Good luck, Inspector. I hope you catch that killer soon. I'll let you out. I hope you find your man, Inspector.
So do I.
Bonjour, Collard.
Oh, hi. It's George Stobbart, the American at the cafe.
Ah, oui.
You said to call if I could help.
Have you any news for me?
You bet. I met a witness who spoke to the clown. And I know where the killer gets his suits.
No kidding. Hey, I'm impressed.
You are? Well, it wasn't easy.
Look, why don't you come here to my apartment?
Fine. Where do you live?
361 Rue Jarry.
Okay, I'll come right over.